Okay, folks have been wondering what life is like on the loop. Let me just say it's arduous, back-breaking, 24 hours on duty. As an example, today is Wednesday, November 9th, and we're in Big Briar Creek, 12 at mile marker 12 on the 10 time. We've come 438 miles from Grand Marina on the Lake Pickwick. And as you can see, it's just a frantic pace trying to keep body and soul together. Wouldn't you agree, my dear?
Yeah, definitely, I agree. Some people would call this Miller time. We call it Docktail time.
Well, one problem, it gets dark at 4:30 p.m., right? We have to eat dinner at 3 in the afternoon, so we go to bed at 7.
But you got to tell the people, what time do you get me up in the morning?
Well, that's true. We got up at 4:45 this morning.
Not just today.
And yesterday and the day before.
Yeah. Before the sun is even up, as soon as the light cracks over the trees, we're out of here.
Which is around 6 o'clock, right?
Yeah. We're
about probably 10 after 6 this morning, we were underway.
If you look at this
creek goes north. We're at mile marker 12 again out of Mobile. And this countryside is not Missouri.
No.
You know you're not in Creve Coeur.
You want to watch out for snakes and you want to watch out for alligators.
Yeah, well, on this trip we have seen one live for real alligator. And that was enough for us.
Other loopers jump in their inflatable dinghies and run up creeks looking for alligators.
But guess what? Not us. Hold on tight. Good luck. Oh. This is Wednesday, July 13th. We're in St. James Harbor on Beaver Island in the northern part of Lake Michigan. We've been here 3 or 4 days. So we've been here since Sunday, really. And it has just been so windy. Oh yeah, yeah. See his blue light?
White Lake going down Lake Michigan. You are looking at a Mack boat in the race.
crowd here in between them and Big Water. And I'm just going to take a whole bunch of video here because this is something you don't get to see too many times in your life. I'm going to swing over this way, get a picture of my handsome husband. Say hi, Tom.
Hello.
And you get a picture of the iPad, which shows how we navigated, or how Tom navigated through the night.
So 40 miles to go, Chicago.
And this is a picture of the Garmin. How deep is the water, Tom?
168 feet. And look for Chicago, straight ahead.
Straight ahead, Chicago, Illinois. A little bit to your left will be Hammond, Indiana. Just a little bit of fog out here. You really can't even quite see the horizon yet. As you start swinging to the south, you'll get a picture of the horizon better. See the horizon there? And the clouds start to look a little pink, which we don't like in the morning. Still, no sun is popping its head up. Promise us another day. Like to go under a bridge in the grand city of Chicago. You can hear the car traffic going over us. All different styles of architecture down here. It seems like every building is unique. See the Trump Tower in the center up there. Pretty much to ourselves today. No barges, so one little fishing boat. A lot different than the weekend until we saw this coming at us. You can see the courthouse, famous court case there where a slave sued for his freedom. That's that tour boat. I'm aboard. We'll search for tomorrow
on every shore. Tuesday, August 30th, we're with Endeavor. Catamaran from Wisconsin, Don and Peg. We're at Hoppy's. Stayed here all last night. Interesting place. Last fuel dock for about 280 miles or so until we get to Green Turtle Bay. So we were topped off with fuel. Tracy, any words?
Let's get out of here.
All right. You heard the Admiral. So we'll see you later. Reflections in the waves spark my memories.
dreams we had. We lived happily forever, so the story goes. But somehow we missed out on the pot of gold. But we'll try.
Already quite a group of boats in here for the night. To their stern, you can see two trawlers anchored. There's three additional trawlers way back in the back. Off to the left, you can see the bow of one sailboat. Our sailboat is right behind
right
that
close
one.
Of S on the Ten Tom Waterway, Tom Fiki. Mile marker, something like 240 something. This just goes on and on. We've not seen anything like this before. I suppose this is the only time we will see it. But now you've seen it too.
We are on the Intercoastal Waterway in between Panama City and Apalachicola. A shrimp boat is going past us. The name of the boat is Southern Air. How big their crew is or where they're going, but I bet they're going to Apalachicola. Very cool boat. Tom slowed down so he could pass us more easily. We were going about 5'2". Looks like maybe he's going 5'4". It's Wednesday, December 7th, and here we are in the Gulf of Mexico. You look at the horizon behind Tom, it is sunset. There is no land in sight. What time is it, Tom?
It's 5 till 6.
5 till 6 in the evening, the sun is setting. The boat on the right there is Tranquility II. The boat on the left is Living Life. All three boats under sail only. Living Life and GH3 have main and jib. Looks like Tranquility has main only. How fast are we going, Tom?
3.6.
And how far are we from our destination?
60.1 nautical miles.
60.1 nautical miles. We're going how fast?
3.6.
What time does it say we'll get there?
Now it's saying 11:44 a.m.
11 a.m. The wind is going to die and the waves are going to settle down. Got a nice roll going on now. When the waves die, we'll, and the wind dies, We'll take the sails in and motor, I'm sure. So here's the bow of the boat, anchor locker with a windlass. The jib is on a roller furler, as you can see. Look here at the main. The main rolls, furls into the mast. We have a tweener, a dodger, and a bimini to keep us out of the sun. I'm going to step on board.
Mention the winches.
Mention the winches. Oh yeah, self-tailing winches. Very cool.
Four of them.
Four self-tailing winches. Nice table, big cozy cockpit, plenty of rooms for guests. Steering wheel folds in at the sides so you can get past it easily. This is the equipment that you will have standing at the wheel for navigation. On the top there will be an iPad. So this is the view you would have standing at the wheel, looking out the front windshield of the Dodger. Oh, bow thruster. Thank you, Tom.
Right here, though. Right there. There's,
okay. This is the add-on bow thruster, which helps you primarily coming in and out of a slip. Totally awesome. Okay, from here you can see very cool doors that go into the cabin. A lot of our friends own trawlers. They think that we sailboaters live in the basement. That's because we walk down steps, in this case five steps, to get into our boat. But we like it that way. This is the main salon. On the left side is one settee where you can sit and watch TV, DVDs, or a guest could sleep there. On the other side is another settee with a custom-made table which was made for this
boat specifically.
Our favorite artwork will be displayed on the wall there. That's an image of Beaver Island, one of our favorite places. You can see the steps I just came down. Underneath those steps with very good access is a 30 horsepower inboard diesel three-cylinder Yanmar engine. On the left side here is our head. It's very exciting. No more porta potty. We now have a marine head with a holding tank that holds 15 gallons. Count them, 15 gallons. The sink is also cool. Sink has hot and cold running water. The faucet on that sink lifts up so it can be used as a shower head. The whole room then becomes a shower. Okay, across from the head is our kitchen, also called a galley. Two burner, stove, gimbaled with an oven. Refrigerator, freezer over here on the side. Just in front of the Raisin Bran boxes is a deep freeze. Above the stove is a microwave, several cabinets, a double bowl sink. Faucet again is hot and cold running water. In the background there you can see the nav station and the electrical circuitry. I forget what that's called. If you swing around past the steps, this is where we will sleep.
Marco Island, Florida. It is just almost sunset. We are trying really hard to get back from Winn-Dixie to our boat on February 1st. Got to go under this bridge, and we're anchored out on the other side of the bridge along with Living Life and another boat that we have not met yet. We'll be staying here one night, then threading our way out about 4 miles for the channels to get out of here and head south tomorrow, probably to Indian Key. I'm going to keep recording because I want you to see where our boat is. Oh, I guess we have to go around that corner where that blue boat is, don't we? Monday, February 13th, the day before Valentine's Day. You're looking at the Highway 1 bridge over part of the Florida Bay. We're coming north. We just left Key Largo. The bridge, to the left of the bridge is Homestead, Florida. I don't know what this development is. The bridge takes traffic from Homestead down to the right across Cross Key to Key Largo and down on the other Florida Keys. A lot of development right here at this bridge. Here's development. Some sailboats at anchor. If I could see around that corner to the right, there's miles and miles of mangrove trees. It's part of the Everglades. At the helm is my particular Valentine, doing an awesome job getting us through these channels. I'm gonna come back around to the front so you can see this bridge. Ooh, look at that boat. That's a pretty one. Two masts. That's a big boat. Don't know what it is. There it is. Okay, we're about to go under this bridge, which is Highway 1. It's kind of fun to see what that's like. And then just beyond the bridge is a cut. It's like a man-made canal that goes, cuts us through Cross Keys so we can continue our journey up toward Miami and then into Fort Lauderdale, where our son is going to fly in to visit us.
Watching the sun bake, all of those tourists covered with oil, strumming my six string on my front porch swing.
March 10th, about 3 a.m., maybe 3:10. The lights to our stern are Old Bahama Bay Marina, West End, Grand Bahama Island, which we are leaving. At the helm, should be a lovely night for a crossing. It'll take us, what, about 10 or 12 hours, Tom, to get to Fort Pierce, Florida.
Yep.
Right now we got a tiny bit of wave action going on, almost nothing.
I'm calling them swells
rather than waves. Swells rather than waves, okay. Ahead of us, we might be able to steer some lights. That's our buddy boat, Gale Rider, a 42-foot sailboat, leading us safely out of the way.
T-minus 1 minute.
Go. Rockport range status. Range green.
T-minus 50 seconds. Upper stage LH2, secure at flight level. 45.
Launch enable. GE, main power off.
Main power off.
Wow, look out there, Tom.
Status check. No Delta.
What is
no
that?
WGS-9.
I don't know what that is, Trace. It hasn't launched yet. There must be a flare of some sort. This is Saturday, April 8th. We are at Raccoon Island, mile marker 509 on the Intercoastal Waterway. We just left Buford, South Carolina. And Tracy, where are we heading to?
Heading to Charleston.
And what are we seeing right here?
That's a cruise ship called the Independence, which goes up and down the Intercoastal Waterway, taking 100 passengers at a time for 14 days. And we heard that the cost is $7,000 per person. So that's probably why he's traveling now, to go through those cuts at high tide.
Well, obviously, they must be having dinner. Otherwise, they're ever going to be out on the deck looking at bucket list here.
Yeah, I'm sure.
This is Monday, April 17th. We just raised anchor, and we're motoring up the Prince Creek to rejoin the Intercoastal Waterway on our way to Myrtle Beach, see Rod and Susie on Behaven. And I just can't get over this anchorage, how peaceful it is.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. These vagabond shoes are lost.
This is June 1st, Thursday.
Exactly.
And we're watching a movie called Sully.
Razor blades, toothpaste.
The airplane crashes in the Hudson River.
Crash lands.
Crash lands, right. But here, where are we at?
We're on the Hudson River. Right behind the Statue of Liberty. You better go out there and look at it.
Get out of here. That's too coincidental. We're just going to have to find out if that's true.
Get out there and see if you see a statue.
All right. So I'm going to go out here. We'll open up the hatch. Open up the hatch. Turning around. Nope, there's the Statue of Liberty. Back of her. Go further around. There's the Manhattan skyline. This has been a magnificent day. Tomorrow we go to the 79th Street Marina, and maybe go to New York. Right now we have Liberty.
I want to wake up in a city that never sleeps and find I'm a number one, top of the list, king of the hill. Town blues. To you, New York, New York, New York.
Hi.
Well, first of all, what are we doing? This is Wednesday, June 14th.
We are baking a cake. Yes.
Why are we baking a cake?
For Abby's birthday. Yes. Special outfit.
Abby, how old are you going to be?
5.
Okay, these are the candles we're going to put on. Cole, what's it going to say?
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Cole, poured the mix in.
Let's see.
Are you going to do the egg or the water, Abby?
I'm going to water.
Pour the egg in very carefully. Ooh, good job.
Not much, just put the water in.
Okay.
Tuesday on the island. Not much going on. The parties are all over. They ended just past dawn. The jumbo drums are beating with the tales from late last night. The store is very heating.
Well, Carol, this is a picture of the Erie Canal headed west. Swinging around, you can see mile after mile, straight as an arrow, perfectly benign and beautiful. We stayed last night at Rome, New York. Tonight we're heading to Toronto.
You can hear them on the Coconut Telegraph saying, who did this and that, this and that, this and that.
Okay, we're at the top of the hydraulic lift block in Peterborough, Canada. And it is starting to lower this speedboat.
From the top, it looks like it's going pretty fast.
Yeah.
If you look at it from the bottom, it's a particular effort.
So Tracy, we're watching this. See it go down.
I missed one little motorboat. The other one did not. And it looks like it's really, really fast.
And there's the corresponding lift coming up.
See how the water level of the far tank is lower than the water level of the structure?
Mm-hmm.
Gossip, but was he that big a fool to do a belly buster high dive and miss the entire pool? And what became of sweet Melissa and the boy nobody knew? Did Ricardo ever find Lander, I swear it's just between me and you. But you can hear it on the Coconut Telegraph by now, everybody.
A railroad carriage carrying two boats up over a highway crossing and back down to the water. The side of the water behind these boats is the Trent River. I believe on the far side is the Severn River, getting close to the end of the Trent Severns, but the Trent Severn waterway certainly is one of the big highlights. The armature that you're seeing actually stops trucks and cars as this carriage goes across. We'll be doing this hopefully later today. I haven't timed it to see how long it takes. It's an incredible feat of engineering. It's engineered so that the carriage stays level the entire time. This was opened, I believe, in 1978. Prior to that, they had a railroad carriage that could only carry one boat at a time, and it was limited to a certain number of tons. And with all the traffic on the waterway, it just couldn't keep up. They were going to put a lock in here, but the moray eel was a problem. They didn't want the eels to get from Lake Huron up into this river to kill the fish. Can you see the wheels on that railroad car? It's so cool. There's two tracks on each side, one for the front wheels and a different track for the rear wheels. That's what keeps the thing level. Here, the two sets of tracks are on the same plane. But as you can see over there, the front track is going up and the back track is going down. The end of a trawler hanging off here. Some folks doing the loop. The lower place, it's called. Very cool.
Comes and goes, comes and goes, comes and goes. La 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 la. It's hump day on the island. The lines all gone dead. All the juicy news is history. I guess everything's been said. But when the eagle flies on Friday and the bars break out the rum, then the joint begins to jump in, and you'll hear those hot lines hum. Ah, put it on the Coconut Telegraph, all the celebration and the stress. Baby, put it on the Coconut Telegraph in 25 words or less. I want to hear it on the Coconut Telegraph, all the celebration and the stress. Baby, put it on the Coconut Telegraph in 25 words or less. This and that.
Cover Portage Cove in the North Channel, returning to our boat, having climbed the cliff this morning. The cliff we climbed was significantly taller than that one. Nice mix of power boats and sailboats in this cove. There's a dandy power boat.
sweet home.
Just the way you look tonight.